What's up? If you're new to my channel, my name is Stephanie. I make a lot of travel vlogs and I'm an American living in Paris. I'm basically like the real life version of Emily in Paris. And I live in France, obviously, and living in Paris and going around Europe for a lot of years, there's still a lot of France that I've yet to explore. So while I love Paris and I'm ultimately a big city girl, there's one place in France that I've always really, really wanted to go, and of all the places in France I had not been to until recently, and that is Monte Carlo and Nice, otherwise known as the French Riviera or the South of France. And as I'm just giving you this intro, I'm showing you the past few days. I had a very hectic week, but I'm still getting this vlog up. Did a lot of exploring, a lot of fun work stuff that I did. But yeah, so the journey to Nice and Monte Carlo, or that whole region, French Riviera, is around 5 hours, 45 minutes by train from Paris, Gare de Lyon. It's not the shortest of journeys. If I could go back in time, or i.e. also if I had more money, I probably would have made this trip longer. I found that I would have been able to stay a lot of days there, but it was still definitely worth the long journey that I had going out there. For reference, my ticket from Paris was around 130 euros, and the accommodation that I picked was about 200 euros, I think, for the night, because it's high season right now. I usually don't share prices, but I'm just giving an idea because I know that the south of France is a really desired travel destination for holidays, especially people who live within Europe. I mean, pretty much every single European I know goes to the south of France when they go on their holiday. Honestly, the train ride, especially the last 2 hours, is really beautiful. You're hugging the coast for the majority of it. So while it's a long journey, I feel like I was also paying for another attraction, was to see all of the beautiful stuff as I was heading down to the south of France. And it was really interesting to finally see Cannes and Antibes and all these really famous, you know, French Riviera cities that you always hear about. And all right, so when I got to Nice, my first impression was this is very colorful. So if you didn't know, Nice was actually once a part of Italy. So all of the street names, they're both in French and in Italy. A lot of package things will still say, you know, we'll still have Italian on them. I was walking around and I heard prego, like I heard people speaking Italian.
I just got to Nice. And so in this video, I'm just gonna like talk about if Nice is overrated, because in all of my years, this is my first time here. I've been living in France for 2 years, been traveling to Europe for over 6 years. And this is like one of the most talked about regions in France. And a lot of French people either love this or hate this. So this video is gonna be comparison if I think this is a place worth coming to. Right off the bat, this seems like a place I would stay for more than one day, but I will let you know by the end of this video. Okay, on y va. As you can't see there, maybe you can see behind me, I have a really cute room. I have a train to Monte Carlo in an hour, so I quickly took a rinse, changed my clothes after my journey. I'm gonna give you a view of the room. A tour of this hotel. Can you tell that I'm frantic as I look for better lighting? And I put my hair up because it's humid here. That was my first impression. It's like Paris, same shopping, same cafes, but Spanish colored, like colored buildings. And then it looks like the Italian Riviera, and then it's humid, which I don't like. But gonna give you a quick tour of this room, and then we're off to Monte Carlo. And yeah.
All right, so when you walk in, besides seeing the towel that I already dropped on the floor,
when you walk in from here, you have the bathroom, really simple but nice rain shower, maybe making some use of. Then you walk over here, you have a little door with all your stuff. Ooh, there's even a mirror here, so hello. And then you have TV here, little desk, chair. You have this really nice balcony that I was not expecting to have. Don't know how much time I'm gonna have to enjoy it, but love that I have it. And then, this is very Paris-like mezzanine style. Don't like that step there, it's a little broken. But you walk up here, you have another TV, and you have a really nice bed. And most importantly, air conditioning, so I'm gonna sleep well for the all of 5 hours that I'm gonna be probably sleeping tonight. But yeah, really nice room. I'm right off of the Promenade des Anglais, which is like the main beach walk, but I decided first I wanted to do Monte Carlo and go to Monte Carlo and then come back and then have the evening here instead of feeling stressed and doing Monte Carlo at the end of the day. So I'm gonna go to Monte Carlo now. Let's go.
So getting to Monte Carlo from Nice is actually extremely easy. I had thought for a long time it was going to be a pain in the ass, for lack of a better word. But Nice is really well connected, public transportation wise, i.e. it has trains and trams. So within Nice, it reminds me kind of like Switzerland at this point. It has trams that are really well connected. but you can also take trains that are high speed to each of the over villages, and the train ride is super beautiful because you're completely hugging the coast. I tried to fuel up before going, and then I ended up dropping said guacamole on the floor, but I would really recommend taking the train. I think round trip, the whole thing costed me 7 or 8 euros. No one checks your ticket on the train because it's just so packed with tourists, at least at this time of year when I went in June, but it was totally worth it. The views were stunning. No one checks your passport for reference also going into Monaco, so it's not something you need to take with you if you're like me and you prefer to leave your passport in the room. But I was pleasantly surprised when I got to Monte Carlo. I really didn't know what to expect, to be honest. As someone who's traveled a lot, first off the bat, I was like, wow, this is gorgeous. It's pretty much the epitome definition of manicured. I don't think I've ever seen any place in all of my travels like this. This is truly the most polished, cleanest, luxurious place I've ever seen. And then topography wise, it reminds me exactly of Luxembourg City. You have weird hills. It's not that pedestrian friendly, but man, is it stunning. I was really, really, really surprised because I didn't expect to have that kind of beauty. Honestly, I think that Monte Carlo is prettier than Nice. But as you probably know, Monaco and Monte Carlo are extremely expensive. So I think it makes for a really, really good day trip or to go even for just a couple of hours and explore. I'm being very serious. I've never seen any place like this in my entire life and all of my travels, and I'd really like to go back again one day. I definitely will for sure.
That one's a rose. A grape.
You could probably spend like a day here. There's not a whole lot to do that's, I don't know, not sightseeing. Like, I did all the major sightseeing things in the 2 hours that I was in Monte Carlo.
Have you ever watched the Selena Gomez movie from 2011, Monte Carlo? This is the hotel that they filmed the exterior shots down there. Woo!
That was me taking my little selfie video outside the casino. So then I finished taking my pictures, whatever, and I headed back to Nice on the train after getting some last nice shots. Again, I really, really love this place and I definitely want to come back with my mom probably. So then I started making my way back towards the hotel. If I could go back in time, I might have done this differently with the little time I had, but hey, it's something to do for next time. But on the tram, I was passing Place Messina and then I walked by the little Notre Dame church that they have in Nice. And I saw downtown a little bit before heading over to Promenade des Anglais.
I share my thoughts as I sit here and have my dinner picnic thing staring at this beautiful view. I've done a lot in a very short time period, and honestly, this is very beautiful. What this reminds me of is a mix of Italy, colorful buildings like Spain, and then kind of like Santorini, but it's much easier to hop from each little village because you have the train. This is a vacation I would prefer over going to Santorini or Greece. I definitely don't think it's overrated. Is it the most amazing place I've ever been? No, but it's not overrated. I think it's a nice city, nice area. It's nice to hear waves crashing. You don't have an actual beach here, this is rock, but you have towns over that have beaches. But unlike Greece or Santorini, you have the train that takes you there instead of going through the bus, so.
No, that was worth it.
So my original plan was to go up Castle Hill, which is apparently a very great viewpoint in Nice, but it was closed by 8 o'clock, which was what time it was now. So then I just ended up walking around the old town, stumbled upon a market, saw some shots. Honestly, if you've traveled a lot of Europe, the old town's not going to appeal all that much to you because it's the same thing over, narrow alleys, little shops, colorful buildings, restaurants, but I still wanted to walk around it. I will say I think it's one of the like nicer of old towns I've seen within Europe. Like if you were to ask me which one's nicer, this one or the one in Stockholm, it's this one. I got myself a gelato because I just earned it after 8.4 miles of climbing in Monte Carlo. Then I made my way back to the room at the balcony. So, Is Nice or Monte Carlo an overrated travel destination? Honestly, I'd say no. I watched a video of a YouTuber, her name's Kaja or something, I can link it in the description box, and she said honestly I think it's a little underrated because so many places in the French Riviera like Cannes or Saint Tropez get a lot more attention than Nice. But in my opinion, from what I saw being on the train back and forth and planning my itinerary, I think Nice serves as the perfect base for traveling in the French Riviera. If you want to go to Saint Tropez or Antibes or Cannes or Monte Carlo, it's the most affordable and it's the biggest city, and it also has a lot of culture and history in itself if you like that kind of stuff. I personally am a big city girl, so that's where I prefer to be based instead of somewhere more remote, etc. But I loved this trip. We'll definitely be coming again for a longer period of time, and I definitely don't think it's overrated. And if you want to see it in under 24 hours, well, I just saw that you can. Thank you.